Assertions in the code are there to stay. We use them for catching errors, which we can also use during testing, but they also serve as documentation tools for programmers because they show what the assumptions of individual methods are, and they show what the individual method is supposed to produce. Now let's apply assertions to another program, an old favorite of ours, our buggy HTML stripper from the first unit. So here again, we have a function to remove HTML markup, which you already know from the first unit. Here as well, a simple assertion would have sufficed to catch the error, namely an assertion that checks for the non-existence of HTML tags in the output. Such an assertion could be something like this. We simply check whether there's any less than sign, that is the beginning of an HTML tag in the output. We assume there's none, and if there would be one, then the assertion would immediately fail. So here comes the quiz. With this assertion, which input would cause the assertion to raise an exception? Is it foo in bold? Is it foo in quotes in bold? Is it foo in bold in quotes? Or is it foo in bold in single quotes? Which of these causes the assertion to fail? Over to you.